Lights, camera, egos. Is it possible that Oscar buzz around someone's acting skills in a movie could begin while the film is still in shooting? Okay, but let's just say that has happened. The media is absolutely rabid with rumours that working actress Marilyn Hack's performance in the family drama Home for Purim is Oscar worthy.
Oh, an Oscar. Oh, okay. No, thank you. I just love the work. It's enough for me. It really is. It's enough.
What mayhem could that cause to the cohesive collaboration of a consummate cluster of cast and crew? Christopher Guest, and I've mentioned him in past reviews for his mockumentaries Best in Show, This is Spinal Tap, Waiting for Guffman, and most recently Mascots. Here he teams up with ensemble cast regular Eugene Levy to write this biting satire on fame, failure and fragility, where the self-image of the characters is the only thing shakier than the walls of the studio set in which they play out their stuff of dreams.
Action.
The air is as heavy as a magnolia blossom, with the weight of 1,000 teardrops on its petal.
This is definitely less mockumentary and more scripted drama, but there's still a great sense of semi-improvised mayhem as a lot of the developing storyline plays out as interviews and hosted segments on a Hollywood gossip show.
And now, Chuck Porter and Cindy Martin.
Well, the much-awaited star-studded Hollywood epic...
Fred Willard and Jane Lynch as Chuck and Cindy host Tinseltown's most titillating telltale infotainment treat. The depth of their shallowness is extreme. Their banter and behaviour is barely even pushed one notch past pedestrian for us to get it and for them to make the point. Why does commercial TV exist? Basically, to promote other things on commercial TV.
Well, the nominations are in and there are surprises galore.
Well, I'll tell you what, Chuck, once again, the voters have spoken.
And while regular updates from the media circus send a ring ensure our propaganda presenters purposefully push the possibility for that paragon of prizes, we also see more and more of the unfolding of the movie within the movie, Home for Purim, as the cast and crew continue filming.
And action.
She's not coming. She's not coming home to see her sick mother.
She'll be home.
It's a simple, touching Jewish family drama set in the South in the 1940s. A dying mother, estranged adult daughter, and a family truth that must be spoken. Okay, it's not Arthur Miller or Tennessee Williams exactly, but it thinks it is.
I know Rachel, Daddy. And she'll come home to see Mama. And she'll come home because it's Purim. We all know what that means to Mama. Or meant.
Was that Rachel's voice I heard? Or am I just going with sugar?
Mama!
And cut. Okay, everybody stay where you are, please.
The key ensemble cast, most of them survivors from past guest films, all have their moments in close-up. That's metaphoric, not literal. Michael McKean, Jennifer Coolidge, Bob Balaban, Parker Posey, Paul Dooley, Rachel Harris, Ed Begley Jr., Jim Piddick, Harry Shearer, Christopher Moynihan, Don Lake, John Michael Higgins, Michael Hitchcock, Larry Miller, and so on and so forth, as well as a few special guest cameos, including Ricky Gervais, Richard Kind and Sandra Oh. Now, the people who make those gossipy, fluffy, infotainment sorts of shows, a lot of them take their craft very seriously. Some of them probably even think they're adding value to society. So if you're a filmmaker like Guest poking fun at their world, could he really expect that his new thing was going to feature on their type of show in a positive promotional way? But clearly Guest doesn't care and probably realises his core audience, they're not the types of people who are either watching shows like Hollywood Now or buy into the hype no matter how much TV time is given over to it. I guess it's a little like the 7 discerning followers of these reviews. Some folk just don't take on board the bull no matter how it's served up. But with that attitude, did perhaps this mirthful mockumentary of movie land madness backfire just a little?
We've gotten away from the family and we make it this. You know what I like? I like when it's misleading in a good way.
Like a horror movie.
Someone's killed their children and made them into cookies, and I want to go see that.
Uh-huh.
Oh,
uh-huh.
Okay. This
earlier awesome. Christopher Guest mockumentaries were made on modest budgets and likely made a profit. Well, certainly Best in Show did, at least enough to justify another film a few years on. But if we can believe all we read on the interwebs, then why shouldn't we? The budget here was around $12 million. Yet it grossed only about $5 million worldwide. Yeah, ouch. The old rule of thumb, a film has to gross about 3 times its budget to break even, given distribution, publicity and other costs. So, by that measure, no one here was planning an early retirement after this one. A bit of a rummage through Rotten Tomatoes also reveals a mixed reaction from the critics, adding salt to the wounds of the poor audience response. Inside the awfully good comedy for your consideration is a purely awful drama dying to break out, says Michael Booth. I hope he was meaning Home for Purim doing the breakout. Lazy, smug and mean-spirited, a mighty disappointment, says Lee Singer. Well, there's a slap, but there was also some praise. The real joy lies in watching some of the funniest actors on the planet nail their characters with penetrating wit and pitiless insight. And director Christopher Guest finds the absurd and shares in the discovery with his cast, but always sees the human, tender truth behind the laugh lines. And I think Mr. Long has really recognised something there under the skin. Guest loves his characters. He recognises they are flawed, some of them reckless and selfish, but some also show signs of fragility. We saw it in the hunting dog owner played by Guest himself in Best in Show, and here we see it in Marilyn Hack and her ultimate buying into all the hype around her. This creative, self-aware woman is fed a taste of the drug of desire and ends up totally hooked. And, well, you have to see the movie to see how that side of her delusion plays out.
Stop me. Stop me. How does the film look? No. Stop me again. How do I look?
Ah, now I can stop you. I can stop you now. You look absolutely amazing.
Okay, good. No, brilliant. I'm sorry I asked.
Incredible.
I didn't mean to bother you. Thank
no,
you.
No, no, no,
thank
no.
you. No, please.
No, I mean, that's...
That's enough. I don't need any... That's good. I'm glad to hear it.
Oh, you know what?
Okay, so it's good.
Catherine O'Hara, another longtime Christopher Guest alumni, is wonderful as Marilyn. And as the Jewish mother in Home for Purim, she delivers an outstanding fourth-rate performance.
And my selfless act was indeed a selfish one.
Because the human I was trying to protect you from, Rachel, turned out to be me.
Acting that bad can only come from someone who is actually really, really good. And her transformation from slightly frumpy middle age to the reinvented and rejuvenated self is both shocking and pitiable. Some of that tender truth behind the laugh lines. Okay, cut, print, that's a wrap. End.